There are some situations where it might be useful to issue a report on site. For example, if you're doing an asbestos four-stage clearance, you would tend to issue the report there and then. Alternatively, maybe you're doing an asbestos survey and there's no samples taken and you just want to give the client the report then and there so they can carry on with some refurbishment or demolition works. So these would be great reasons to issue the report on site. Of course, if there's further work to do in the office, for example, if you need to upload PDF files to your reports, then this isn't probably going to be a very good solution. Instead, you probably want to use the dashboard to create the reports. Also, if you need to wait for something, for example, lab results, then, you know, it's going to be more convenient to create the reports in the office when you get those back. Now let's dive into a job and I'll show you how this feature works. It's very straightforward. Okay, so I'm going to go into this Acme Co job here. And I'm going to scroll down to find the report I'm interested in, which is this one here. Now you can see at the top, we have this option which says select layout. So depending on the template you're using, there may be one or several layouts which you can use to present the data in a report. And these can vary from one template to another, but they can also present the data in different ways. So the asbestos survey report that I'm currently using has several layouts for management surveys, refurbishment surveys, and so on. You'll need to select the one that you're interested in from here. We have a separate video on layouts, so please check that out if you get a chance. Okay, so let's say we want to render a management survey for our client. We can select that one from the dropdown. Now you'll see the options button has now turned blue to indicate there's some more options here. So we've got a choice at this point. We can either grab the report URL and simply send that to a client. They can then open that in their web browser and download the report from there. That might be convenient if you think the reports could be very large and you don't want the hassle of sort of trying to transfer it by email or something like that. Alternatively, you can actually preview the report from here and then download the report yourself if you want to. So let's start by clicking the View Report button to preview the report in our browser. And if we just give that a second. So here the report has loaded and you can see it's not really designed for mobile necessarily. It's more designed for a browser, but you can still see what's going on, you know, and you can scroll around and things like that. The options to copy the URL and download the PDF right here at the top if you need them. So this is great just to give the report like a quick eyeball and just make sure everything looks correct, which it does. And we may just want to issue that to our client there and then. So here I am back on the mobile app. And the second option I want to show you is to copy the report URL. This is a great approach if you don't want to actually have the hassle of copying the file to your client, like sending it via email, like I say. You can just send them a link instead. So to do that, tap the copy URL button here. You can see that's copied it to my clipboard. And then if you just open up your browser and simply paste the URL into the browser here, you'll see it'll take me straight to that report preview like we had before, except this time I'm using it on my desktop browser, not my mobile phone browser. So this is how the report is really meant to be viewed, you know, on a browser, on your laptop or desktop machine. So it's going to be a lot easier to navigate this way as compared with, you know, trying to do that on the mobile app. Now I just want to show you one more thing, and that is that the layout that you select is remembered. What do I mean by that? Well, because we've selected the management survey layout against this report, if we go back up a level, you'll now see that we have this management survey just under the report title. Now, if we go in and we change this to, say, demolition report and go back up a level, you'll see that's changed to reflect the new layout we selected. So we didn't have to save it. Just by selecting the layout, it would be remembered. This can be really helpful if you need to remind someone on site what type of survey they're actually doing. So instead of using the project field, we've got a separate video on that to record the survey type, you could do it this way instead. And just one more thing I'd like to mention. If you're offline, you won't be able to preview or share the report URL on the mobile app. That's because there's no way to send data to our servers and actually render the report. You'll have to get an internet connection first before you can do this. And if you do try to view the report while you're offline, you're going to get a message telling you to connect to the internet first. So just to recap, you can preview reports or share report URLs using the mobile app, as long as you have an internet connection. This is going to be helpful if you want to issue a report there and then on site, but it's not going to be so useful if you have some more work to do in the office, for example, uploading PDF files to your reports, in which case you want to use the dashboard to preview the reports and share the report URL.